blueprints into a functioning platform. So the building began, a program that showered multi-million pound contracts and job opportunities onto what was becoming a lean market for the construction industry. The contract to build the 20,000-ton jacket was awarded to McDermott in Scotland. 24 modules for the production and life support facilities were to be built at yards around Britain and Europe, the massive deck sections in Spain. Then the real headaches began. For the marathon men out on the fabrication sites, for the managers operating from the London headquarters at Marathon House, there were challenges all the way. Anticipating problems, identifying them, tackling them before they knocked the critical path off course, scrutinizing actual progress against planned progress, keeping contracts on schedule.
The esprit de corps that generates on one of these projects where people are thrown into intense pressures to see that they meet milestone dates, a scheduled program, that nobody wants to be the individual that drops the ball and said that we couldn't do it. That creates a spirit amongst the people working on the project that leads toward everyone working harder to ensure the success of the program.
Meanwhile, other milestones were being achieved. In fact, 74 of them, all underwater. The oil pipeline inched its way south along the 74 miles from Bray to the Forties field to link into the main pipeline to the landfall north of Aberdeen and then on to the tanker terminal in the Firth of Forth. Early summer 82 and the fabrication deadlines have been met. The modules move onto the barges for the installation phase. And the jacket's also ready for the long tow to Bray.
We probably had the fastest response time of any project. Our chain of command was short, the ability to make decisions was rapid, and it paid off in the form of a very successful project. It's a style that we will stay with for all of our North Sea developments. It's a style we'll stay with on any international operation. It's consistent, I think, with all of our background and training that if you want a job done well, you got to do it yourself.
The senior management team from Findlay joins the UK managers for the biggest show in the company's history. The date, June the 9th, 1982. Then the weather, predicted calm, begins to look uncertain. 3 a.m. and the orders given for the final countdown to launch. The sea fastenings are cut. This is the most critical moment of the entire project. The weather worsens, but there's no stopping now. The jacket has to go.
Just a magnificent event of man over his environment, and tremendous work by the team we had in place here and the contractors to bring this beautiful job off.
What's your head?
75 meters southeast elevation.
05.5, okay.
When a job goes almost perfectly, it's difficult to appraise it other than being perfectly done. It's absolutely a beautiful job.
A whole summer lies ahead for the installation phase of the platform. First, the jacket must be secured to the sea bed. Using an underwater hammer, piles that are more than 100 yards long are driven down into the bedrock. Then a huge crane barge, capable of lifting 3,000 tons at a time, begins its sequence of lifts. First, the deck sections to support the topside load of 32,000 tons. Then the modules, stacked up in three levels, 400 feet high, creating this man-made island of technology. The entire offshore installation is completed in just 57 days, a North Sea record. Now all is ready for hookup. This is no ordinary check-in, no ordinary flight, and these, let's face it, are no ordinary passengers. The Bears are heading for Bray.
Attention, please. Passengers for the Bray Alpha, please proceed to the departure area.
For the next 12 months, this army of construction workers will crowd through Aberdeen, flying one of the busiest air routes in Britain.
5-6 Foxtrot Bristow's taxi 1120, airborne 1125 for the Bray.
They're taking part in the greatest offshore operation ever mounted on any single British North Sea project. 155 miles out to sea, in one of the world's roughest places, they're heading for hookup, joining together the various modules that will transform Bray into a functioning production platform. So 1,900 men start clocking up the man hours, with another 1,900 onshore waiting for the next shift. Supervising hookup from day one, Gordon Coulson.
We're building the biggest Meccano set in the world out here. And at times we've got close to having more flights in and out in a single day than many provincial airports. We had, for most of the contract, 3 5-star hotels out here. The sheer logistics, I think, has been the thing that staggered us all to begin with.
That's running at $1 million a day, productive manpower's everything. Helping a Bear to perform requires complex logistics that reach out to Marathon's operational headquarters in Aberdeen and to the supply base at Peterhead.
We've got some coach bolts in order, which Peterhead have been on saying it's ultra urgent.
We want all 10 to heliport, please.
You guarantee that you'll either have a delivery by air freight this afternoon or first thing in the morning.
That doesn't give us a problem with seats or anything like that.